evening, which is the awarding of the Golden Pen Award. And I'm not going to be awarding it. I'm going to ask somebody who we all know, Lisa Appignanesi, to come and talk to you and to give the pen and to tell you why we chose the person we chose. So, Lisa, thank you.
Five Gates of Ivory, Jerusalem the Golden. Well, they were just astonishingly wonderful books. But this woman who had written all this was also this vivid, forthright, argumentative person who cared passionately about justice and was deeply engaged with righting wrongs. For Maggie, as you know, the Golden Pen is an award which is given not simply for the great task of writing, but also for that extra plus, that engagement. And you have had a lifetime's engagement of distinguished service.
Well, I think I'm allowed to say a few words of thanks and gratitude. I feel deeply honoured to receive this award. I've been a member of PEN, both active and inactive, for many years. I was introduced to PEN, I think, by Frances King, whose life we celebrated this year, and by Angus Wilson. And I have done my bit standing on street corners and climbing up interminable stairs to committee meetings and writing letters to prisoners. You have all supported PEN so wonderfully. You've had wonderful presidents, directors, at boards of trustees. The volunteer and the staff have been superb. And PEN has gone into yet new realms in recent years. And I'm very, very proud to be honored and associated with it. I have been writing for a very long time, as Lisa very tactfully pointed out. In fact, I think the Golden Pen celebrates my golden wedding to literature, because 50 years ago, I had given birth to my first son, and I had almost finished my first novel. So that's 50 years as a writer. And I can tell you, as you know, that writing doesn't really get any easier as you get older. You never learn the formula. You have to begin again every time. And it is wonderfully encouraging to receive this award for a lifetime's work, which makes me feel my life has been very good. On the subject of freedom of speech, which is so close to Penn's heart, and censorship, I would like to say that I did run into a bit of trouble in the United States on my last visit and vowed I would never cross the Atlantic again. I had the honor of being boycotted by Fox News for my views on about 6 months later, an award I'd been given by St. Louis libraries, they tried to snatch it back because of my views on Iraq. Now, I hope nobody in PEN will ever snatch back my own PEN, which I shall treasure. And thank you all so much for choosing me and giving me this great pleasure. Thank you.